everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Temi, a software engineer working in the UK. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about what you can expect from junior software engineering technical interviews, and I'll also give some tips based on my own experience. Everything I talk about in this video will be from the perspective of someone who's based in the UK, so that is something to keep in mind whilst you're watching. Before I dive into the video, don't forget to like and subscribe so that you can see more content from me. Generally, before the technical interview stage, it's likely that you'll have a call with a recruiter or someone in HR, and then you'll get a behavioral interview, which is done so that the company can find out more about your experience and your personality as well. So after doing the phone interview and a behavioral interview, you can then expect to do a technical interview. Or you might be asked to do several technical interviews if you are applying at a bigger company. In my experience, I found that smaller companies and startups here in the UK are likely to ask you to do take-home tests, a technical presentation, or they might just want to have a technical conversation with you for a few hours. Whereas big or international companies are more likely to give you a live coding test or a take-home coding test to complete. Generally, the type of technical interview or assessment you'll get will depend on the size and the type of company. So the first type of technical interview that you could get is a technical presentation. And this is something that I actually got myself. So what happens is that you might be asked to present a 10 to 15 minute presentation on a technical topic of your choice. And you can expect that the interviewers will ask you in-depth questions about whatever topic you've chosen to present. In my case, I decided to present a weather application that I'd recently built. I was being interviewed by two senior engineers, the founder of the company, and then someone else who worked in HR business. I spoke about the tech stack I used and why I chose it, and went into detail about trade-offs. So for example, why I chose certain programming languages over others, or why I chose certain frameworks. I also talked about the planning stage, where I went into detail about the market and user research that I did. I then went into detail about how I developed the app and how I created the server. Afterwards, I talked about how I set up the front end, how I made certain API calls, and how I dealt with the JSON response. Lastly, I talked about some of the issues I faced and any improvements that I was planning to do at the time on my application. Some of the questions I got in response to my presentation were, how did I intend to test the app with my users? What were the performance issues that I might have been concerned with? And what were the benefits of CI, so continuous integration, and Git? So expect a lot of questions around whatever it is that you've presented. In terms of how I actually prepared for this interview, I personally made my presentation and went through it with my mentor, and together we came up with any possible questions that they could have asked me. As I designed and built my weather app from scratch, I knew the project like the back of my hand. So to prepare, you really just want to make sure that you do a little bit of reading around your project. So why you chose certain tech stacks, any potential issues with your project, and just prepare for any other questions. Following the technical presentation and the Q&A session afterwards, the second part of the interview that I had was an in-depth technical conversation, which lasted a few hours or so. Technical conversations will be based around your CV, your experience, the position you've applied for, and just everything around that. It's important that when you're preparing for this stage of the interview, that you know your CV really, really well, because after all, it's all about you. Make sure you know any projects that you've mentioned on your CV extremely well. And whilst revising your projects, think about the extremely challenging parts of them. If you're discussing a group project, then have a think about where you played a major role, because the interviewers want to know about you and not really about the people that you worked with. If there are any technical areas of your project that you don't know that well, make sure you revise them because you will be asked about them. So overall, you should consider the challenges, technical decisions, mistakes, choices of your chosen tech stack and the trade-offs, and anything that you would do differently. To find out more about what you should and shouldn't do at this stage, you should have a read of this book called Cracking the Coding Interview by Gail McDowell. It mainly contains algorithm and coding questions and their solutions, but there's also a section at the beginning where she talks about things to do on your CV and things not to do, and also how to approach behavioral interviews as well. So this book has a lot of good information in it. I will leave a link down below. If you're a university or college student, then you can probably expect to be asked questions about your assignments, dissertations, any projects that you've worked on, or even any internships that you've done. Another type of technical test that you might get is a take-home test. This could be a data structures and algorithms question, or you might be asked to build some form of web application. I interviewed at a big global company and was actually given a take-home HackerRank algorithms test to do. The test was timed and I had 90 minutes to complete 3 questions. So 2 out of 3 questions were algorithm questions, and the third was a series of multiple choice questions about basic data structures and object-oriented programming principles. That was probably the hardest one I've done to date, and I needed a 60% to pass, but I only got 40. So a tip here would be to just make sure you know your data structures and algorithms really well. You can use sites such as LeetCode, HackerRank, Codility to practice solving algorithm questions. For junior or entry-level roles, you can expect easy LeetCode questions, but you might get some medium ones too, so just make sure you're prepared. If you're interviewing at a startup or smaller company, it's more likely that you'll be given a take-home test. If you do get given a take-home test, just take your time and use whatever resources you can, but just remember that you will be asked questions about how you built the app and what your thought process was whilst building it. So make sure whatever you do, however you solve it, you can explain that later on. Another type of technical interview that you might get, and I'm sure this is one that everyone dreads, I know I did, is a live coding test. It's normally big or international companies that will give you these, but really any company can ask you to do a live coding test. So just make sure you know what you'll be tested on before you go into the interview. 9 times out of 10, you will be told what you'll be tested on before you go into the interview, but always ask just to make sure. So live coding sessions will involve you coding in front of the interviewer, normally virtually. You may be given a LeetCode or HackerRank style question, and the interviewer will actually watch you solve it in real time. So the format would be like if you were to hop on a Zoom call with someone and then they ask you to share your screen and you would code in front of them. You may be asked to code in several different coding environments, such as a LeetCode or HackerRank style environment, or an IDE, or even a text editor. So just make sure you're prepared for all scenarios. Here are a few quick tips for when you are doing a live coding test. The first one is to speak out loud. It's all well and good being able to solve the coding problem, but the interviewer wants to see that you can communicate your ideas and talk about what you're doing, because after all, when you get into the workplace, you will be having to explain your code to other engineers on your team or walk them through what you've done. So if you're not able to explain what you're doing in the interview, they might take this as a sign of not being a good communicator. The next one is to try and relax. I know that this is a lot easier said than done, but the more practice you do beforehand, the more relaxed you'll be. Almost all of the time, the interviewer actually wants to see you succeed, so they will help you along the way if it looks like you're stuck. The last tip is to just be honest when you're stuck. This shows the interviewer that you can admit when you're lost, and it also means that they can help you out and nudge you in the right direction. So I hope you've all learned some things from this video that you can hopefully take away and apply in your future interviews. Thank you all so much for watching, and good luck if you're currently interviewing. Bye, see you in my next video.